All right, someone, this is going to be a very quick 10-minute run through because I've basically been working on it most of the evening. And I basically just want to get some feedback because I'm running out of space to put the things in. Like, I've created the little spare room. That used to be the office, the boss's office. That's now that one there. The boss didn't have his own bathroom, so I've created him a master bathroom to go with his master bedroom. You already know about these two little bedrooms. I'm guessing those are two lieutenants. There's a little utility room, a spare cupboard room. This is going to be. What's going on there? Toilets for the upstairs for those two lieutenants, I guess, and for guests who go to the dinner room up here or whatever it is, dining room. The only one I've not been able to do is let's just hide the ground floor for a sec. This ginormous, I don't know what you call this room, lounge, I suppose. There's that bedroom there and that lounge. I haven't got space to put both of them in there, so it has to be one or the other. So what I'm thinking is either the outside we create some barracks for all the extra guards, or we create a basement and we put the barracks down there for the guards, so basically bunk beds and the like. And this bedroom here can be moved down there as well, per captain a guard or something, I don't know. This one here, I could open this room and turn that into a small lounge, take that door out so that people that are in here can go into there. Or we can make this table smaller and turn this into a dining room come lounge area. So one half is the dining room, the other half is lounge area, and then make that a bedroom as originally planned. You can see there I've started giving you some basic ideas on how to we're going to seal off all the different rooms. Basically, that gap that the entities leave is exactly one square at grid 8, which is perfect. So you can run your little brushes, your cork brushes down inside those. Now these models are shadow casting, so it doesn't matter that we put on caulk in there. Something else I learned, I was going to put big square pillars that I've seen Spring Hill use, but I don't know if he told anyone, but I only discovered this. But basically you've got these two walls and they obviously look messy because you're missing a corner, but I think he must have done it. Because they line up perfectly, apart from a little bit of texture issues, but you're not really going to see that in game. But it gives you that nice corner, so like that obtuse corner for creating L pieces. So that thing I said the other day about having a reverse L shape, well, that's it with that corner piece, with the obtuse corner piece. So happy days. I haven't placed any lights, but I've placed the doors in such a way that we can. The lights can be placed nicely. If they're going to go on the wall, that wall there now, in between those three doors, the light can go there, for example. What else? I was specific about here. I finished the bedroom in the previous run through. Yeah, so all I really did was fleshed out that bathroom, this office, that cupboard, and the guest bathroom and toilets, etc. The bits that are missing from there in a different layer. Let's do that now. I started pulling over entities from the other building, so all the info location separators, the info location entities for the rooms that you've put them in. I've also created a blue room. So basically all of the entities that I found dotted around your map, I've put them all in this cork-based room, which is basically how you should have been doing it to begin with. It's part of the start map that I mentioned. What else? Most of the rooms have a fireplace in them. The master bathroom has a little furnace. And most of these bits, actually, the layout of stuff, I grab from my BCD bathroom that I made. This is a little flap toilet. The only thing we need to put on there is a, I don't know what you call those things, piss pot, I suppose, that goes underneath here. Chamber pot, that was it. That the servants or whatever, guards, the lowest guards will pick up. What else? You can discard. Oh, that's interesting. What's that? Area data. I don't know what that is. I've never seen that before. You'll have to explain to me what that is. And let me know about the lounge, you know, whether I'm going to put it in that bit there. I might even create some custom modules that include an archway, so, you know, guests can go, or like I say, we make this into a half and half lounge, half dinner area. I think the dinner area can go that way and the lounge area can go up there. Anyway, let me know. What else was significant? Had to trim sec. Make that an entity. No, make func static and make non-solid, because the distance between that beam and that top stair there needs to be 12 units, otherwise AI and the player won't be able to get underneath it. They'll keep whacking their head into that. And I've sealed the room there, so it's not a problem about it leaking, etc. Oh, what the hell's happened there? Oh, it's because I did the texture on, and then I selected the whole flipping brush, not just the surface. I've put a few more things in there just to placeholders like those. They need to be taller. I need to create a model of those, which I think I have for prefab somewhere around. Need to place some stuff in here. Might even turn that into a little cubby hole. Or use the stairs that I made so that we can make stairs to go into the basement from there, or choose a different location to go into the basement. I don't know where you do it from though, other than underneath the bottom of those stairs. Or have the basement have a dumb waiter that comes up to the kitchen. Where would we put that? We could put that here, we could put it there. And then the basement could be here. And the basement, you can only gain access to it, say, from outside. Give another way for the player to get into the building instead of all of these open windows. So they break into the basement, get into the dumbwaiter, come up through the dumbwaiter, into the kitchen. Classic Thief 2 gameplay. Right then, that's nearly 10 minutes. I think you've had a look around of all the stuff that I've done. Let me know. There's obviously still a lot of tweaking to do. I've still got to place all the lighting. At some point, I'm going to stop and hand the map over to you. Like, all the paths will have to be moved and changed and whatnot. So I can leave that to you, but I'm happy to help where you run into pathfinding issues. There's no monster clip, but I will do that before I hand the map, because obviously everything's different inside this new building layout. I will go through and seal all the rooms, etc., applying vis portals. So in this instance, we'd have basically one there, one there, one on every doorway, one there, one to seal the horizontal one, one there, etc. But on a map this size, it should perf quite well, even without you doing that, but it's good work in practice. Basically, you'd have them there and there, because when the player's in these hallways, everything beyond that doesn't get rendered. Put one there as well, one there, one there. You'll see anyway when I do it, and I'll have a longer length video for tomorrow. But there you go, fella. Let's hide the back to the ground floor. Move that up to the first floor. What else have I done? I haven't really tweaked the ground floor all that much, although I've added the basic privy and a wash bowl to those two toilets. Privy looks a bit more busy now. Pantry looks a bit more busy now. Brought some more entities over, models that you'd put in your map up here. But pretty much everything that we can take from there is now in there. The kitchen needs some work, like that thing there as a placeholder. At the moment looks a bit weird. In fact, that kitchen's a bit on the large side. What we could do is have the stairs to the basement from there, for example. Anyway, won't know until we go into game to see if it's too big or not. Right. Oh, and obviously the foyer needs detailing, as well as the gaming room, etc. So all that stuff will have to get pulled over. And I might have to build you that roulette table. I get sounds from somewhere. We'll make up a sound definition. Right, that's it. I'll see you again tomorrow.